Hello, welcome to today's modular classroom. Today we are going to see how to set up the environment in the Google Classroom. So we have seen many videos related to Google Classroom. In today's video, we are going to see how to set up the environment of the Google Classroom and how to select a theme and how to handle the notifications in the Google Classroom and how we are able to work with this environment. So first, when you type the classroom.google.com, it will automatically take you. This will take you to the main menu where the classes, it is denoted by three straight lines. Look at the cursor pointer. So this is the three straight lines, and this is the place where you can go for some settings related to the overall Google Classroom. And here you manage four classes. So first, if I click this three straight lines, you can have the total settings of all the classes which you are enrolled and the classes which you are teaching, etc. First, I'm going to the first class. This is the first BSc Max class, and there is some class code here. Here, how to select a theme. So the theme is one where you can select from here. Look at the mouse pointer. Here you can select the theme, and when you click on that theme, it will take you to a gallery where the list of themes are available. So this is a general theme. If you look into this tab, either you can select a general theme or any other theme. So English or history, the people related to this English or history. Then there is other tab where the maths and science related themes are available. There is arts, and also there is sports and other general themes. So now I'm going to the maths and science. So from this maths and science, I am selecting this theme math.jpg and select the class theme. So now we can see that the class theme gets changed. So after selecting the theme, you can also go for upload photo. If you have some personal themes, if you want to enroll, you can go to the upload photo option and you can select a photo from your gallery to upload in the theme. Then the next thing is notifications. How to handle the notifications in the Google Classroom? So you have to go to the main bar, which is denoted by the three straight lines. This is the notifications can occur for a variety of reasons in the Google Classroom. This is the main dashboard. It will take you to the main dashboard of the Google Classroom. And from the main dashboard, we can select the classroom main menu. And from there, we can go to the settings, which is at the bottom of the menu list. This is the menu. And from the bottom of this menu list, you can find the settings. And you can click on to that settings to handle with the notifications. So the teachers and the students will receive the notifications for a variety of reasons. And we can handle these notifications in this settings. So you can change the profile picture if you want. And below the profile picture, you can find the notifications. There are a lot of notifications. The comments on your post. What is the comments? When you post, go for a post, the students can comment on that. If you enable this, students can comment. If you disable, the students can't make even a comment. The comments that mention you, private comments on work. So every private individual comments on each work the students submit, if it is enabled, that can be made. If it is disabled, the student can't make any private comments. Classes you are enrolled and classes you teach. So there are two subdivisions. Classes you are enrolled. For this, if you turn on the notifications for four options, work and other posts from teachers, return work and grades from your teachers, invitations to join class as a student, due date reminders for your work. These are all the notifications for the classes you are enrolled in. And for the classes you teach, late submissions of student work, resubmissions, invitations to co-teachers, scheduled post published or failed. So for these things, you can enable the notification or disable the notification if you wish. You can enable. And one more thing is, you will get the notification in the both in the class and also in the email. If you don't want to receive the email notification, you can turn off. Class notifications, turn email and mobile notification on off for a class. This is the place where you can turn on or off the notification. Here it is mentioned email and also the mobile notifications. So for all my classes, all the notifications are being enabled. If you want to turn off any notifications, immediately you can turn off. This is where you can handle the notifications. So next we can come to the classes, and when you come to the class, any particular class setting can be handled by the settings at the top right corner. And if you click on the settings, the class details can be handled, the name of the class, class description, what is this description of this class, what is the paper you are going to handle, what is the section, what is the room number, and what is the subject. These details can be entered, and general details, what is the class code, what is the stream, and the classwork on the stream, show deleted items. So class code, here if you go to the class code, there are four options: display, copy, reset, disable. Copy, you can copy, and if you want some other students, lateral entry students can be made to enter into the class by making a copy and then sharing them with the email or WhatsApp. So if you want to reset, the code can be changed. You can reset the code. If I'm clicking, see, the code can be reset. So now the code changes. So the class code can be reset. It is not fixed. You can reset the code in the Google Classroom. Just if you click the reset in the general settings of a class, you can reset the code. And you can disable the code, or you can display the code. Whatever options we can want, we can do. And stream, what are all the options this is enable, you are enabling for the student? Student can post and comment, student can only comment, only teachers can post and comment. What is the option you wish to choose? You can select the option. If you choose only teacher can post or comment, only you can do. And if you enable the student to post or comment, the student can do. So this is the setting which you do in one particular class. In classwork on the stream, it shows condensed notifications, show attachment and details, hide notification. So on this, you can select any one of the option which you wish. Then show deleted items. So deleted items can be viewed only by the teacher. We can see here only teachers can view the deleted item. Grading, grade calculation. Overall grade calculation, we can give set in the grading. If you specify the total points or weighted points, if we give that, based on that, the overall grade calculation can be done. Then grade categories, already we have seen there is a rubric system of grading which we have uploaded in the last video, and you can go back and see that. And also you can look into the description for other featured videos of this modular classroom, and keep subscribed and stay tuned for our further notifications and other further videos. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned.